Welcome to UGC NET Online Pre-Coaching. Today I will discuss question number December 2006, part 1. Already I have completed June 2006. Today I will start a new series, December 2006. In this, first we will see first question of December 2006. Which of the regular expression corresponds to this grammar? Most of the time I told you finite automata is very important subject. Definitely will get 8 to 10 questions. Please go through. First you should cover finite automata with compiler design. Okay, look at this question. They are given three productions, S, A, B and A, S. A is a production, one more production, A or AA, B is one more production, tends to B. They have given three production. Is it generates expression A star B plus or A star B or AB whole star, AB whole star? To know this one, we need to just substitute, it is like a recursive function. Just initially you go for where this is S, AB and AS is the starting regular language it generates. Now go on, we'll substitute A in this expression. Capital letters indicates non-terminals and small letters indicates terminals. Okay, who are don't know the finite automata, please go through it. These are basic things. Now in these two, first is look at all three productions. These are three productions are given. Now we'll start for starting symbol S of AB. You may start S of AB or S of AS, it's both. You may start which one, but most of the time you may get in both. You may start with any of the production, you'll get the answer. That type of grammar is called ambiguity grammar. We'll discuss later on. First, start with the starting symbol S of AB. Now what is your A? A is A or AA. In this first letter A, you may substitute this A or A of A. I think I have written reverse, sorry for this. A of A, this one. So I will substitute this A is A of A. Okay, A of A and B. What is your A? Again you may substitute A of A. Means what? Again you may substitute A of A, or else you may stop anywhere. A of A, it is stopped, but how many times it A generates we don't know, because it may be A star indicates star, means what, closer, star closer, it may generate one character or it may null character or it may be infinite character. So this A, this capital A may generate n number of A's. And what is your B? B is only one symbol, that is terminal symbol. It will not generate any letter next, so B is the stop. But A, how many A's? It may be n number of A's. That's why you may write A, this is first A, and A of A. This A is generates n number of times, that's why it is A raised to star. So your production is A raised to star B. So check it. This is AA raised to star B plus there is no plus here, so definitely it is strikeout. And this is AA A star B, this is the answer. Here AB whole star, just looking at the question, if you know good in regular expression and context pre-grammar, you can strike out this option also, because B is only one time, but it is B raised to star, means what, it will not generate n number of times, so you may strike out directly. Here plus, directly you may strike out. Here also AB whole star, this is also wrong option. Without looking the production, without performing the operation, you can answer easily. Option is B. Okay, I hope it's clear. Now we'll go for the proposition negation of Q or P is equivalent to. Actually I am solving all the questions for original question papers of UGC NET. In this original question paper, they have not mentioned any options. I think so. December 2006, it is misprinted. I think two questions same. So I will not discuss anything about this. I will not assume maybe these are the options. I will not do anything. So left it. It is undefined. Okay, because we don't know. I think printing mistake. Next one more. The number of edges in the complete graph with n vertices is equivalent to. This is already I explained. If the graph is complete, what is complete graph? All the edges should have unique one edge from every other vertices. So a complete graph with a simple undirected graph in which every pair of distinct vertices connected by a unique edge means what? This vertex should connect with all other vertices unique edge. This is a complete graph. So how many edges? If it is complete graph, definitely it is n into n minus 1 by 2. I think this graph will use in mesh topology. Okay, so I hope complete graph means what? A complete graph is a simple undirected graph in which every pair of distinct vertices is connected by unique edge. Means what? One vertex is connected with the all other vertices. So this one asked just June 2006, question number 2. Next we'll go for which of the following is not true. Again printing mistake. They have not given option A, C, D, so without knowing it's difficult to answer. So definitely it is undefined. I will not discuss anything about this. Next we'll move for question number 5. If a square minus b square is a prime number where a and b belongs to n, then what is your option? A square minus b square is equal to 3, or a square minus b square is equal to a minus b, a square minus b square is equal to a plus b, or a square minus b square is equal to 5. Let us assume and take some options. Consider a is equal to 2, b is equal to 1, so a plus b is equal to 3. So a square minus b square means 2 square minus 1 square is 4 minus 1 is 3. So a square minus b square is equal to 3. Look at one more. A is equal to 3, b is equal to 2. So a plus b is equal to 5. A square minus means 3 square is 9, 2 square is 4, 9 minus 4 is 5. So again you'll get a square minus b square is equal to a plus b. So option is C is right answer. Next look at the hexadecimal equivalent of 10111 means binary they have given. We need to find of hexadecimal of these two numbers. Just you take multiples of 2 to solve this one. You know how to convert binary to hexadecimal, but you do it in a easy way. You take just powers up to 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 4. Means what? 1 into 2 raised to 4, 0 into 2 raised to 3. Just write this one. You will get answer is 23. Means 2 raised to 4 is 16, 2 raised to 3 is 0 into, leave it. 2 raised to 2 is 4, 16 plus 4 is 20, 20 plus 2 is 22 plus 1. So 23. And this one is 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 0 is eliminated. 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3. 2 raised to 3 is 8, 2 raised to 1 is 2, 8 plus 2 is 10 plus 11. Sorry, 14. So you'll get 8 plus 4 plus 2 is, you'll get 14. So 23. Now you multiply these two, you'll get 322. This is the decimal number, but you need to convert this one in a hexadecimal number. So 322 divided by 16 is 20. Again, 16 1 just 60, remainder is 2. So 142 of the given binary number is equivalent hexadecimal number is 142. Option is C. I hope it's very clear. If you know without doing these options, you can directly answer, because this is just multiples 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 4. 2 raised to 4 is 16. 2 raised to 3 is eliminates. You take it directly. This is 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3. 2 raised to 3 is 8. 2 raised to 2 is 4. 8 plus 4 is 12. 2 raised to 1 is 2. So 14. You eliminate these intermediate steps. If you are comfortable, no problem. Means what, if you have enough time, don't worry about it, but don't do it any mistakes. Okay, next we'll go for an example of self complementing code is 8421 code or gray code or XS3 code or 7421 code. Self complementary code, it is a property, it's a direct answer, that is XS3 code. XS3 code is known as self complementary code because it can easily be complemented up to 9's complement to perform addition in the case of subtraction. Means what, you can perform up to 9's complement once you'll get all the values of 1's complement. So, or self-complement code is also known as self-complementing code or reflective code, as 1's complement of any number is available within 10 numbers. That's why it is a self-complementary code. I hope it's clear. It's a direct property. So option is C is the right answer. Next we'll go for a sum of products expression can be implemented with dash logic code. Sum of product, product of sum, using AND of OR NAND of OR, AND of NOT OR of AND. Sum of products, that is first multiply then add. That's why sum of product, sum it will comes in between, product is operators, in between, so operands. So sum of product, first multiply then add. So sum of product is AND of OR. Product of sum is OR of AND. So be careful. So sum of product is AND of OR. Option is A is right answer. Now look at the characteristic equation of a D flip flops. Already I have explained in December 2004 question number 10. It may ask any actually in 2004 they asked JK flip flop, characteristic of JK flip flops, but here they asked characteristic of D flip flops. So it may ask any character, it may be SR flip flop in the future, but you should know all the characteristics of all flip flops, because anytime it may changes, only change the name of the flip flop. That's why you should know like these questions. Once you get this type of questions, you just list out related to all characteristics. Sometime if they ask formula, you should list out all the formula, because next time it may be change the name different, it may ask different formulas. So you just go through it. T flip flop, characteristic of T flip flop, this one, and characteristic of SR flip flop, this is characteristic of JK flip flop, and characteristic of D flip flops. Okay, you should list out all the characteristics. It may ask any question, you can answer it. Okay, now you can answer easily. The characteristic equation of a D flip flop is D. This is, so option is B. This is characteristic Q equal to D. I hope it's easy. What I'm trying to explain, you just list out all the formulas, all important properties and characteristics. Just list out all subjects like this only. Next we'll go for which of the following logic is the fastest. Just look at in 2 years this is asked third times, repeated question. This one is a fixed question almost. It will ask one question for characteristics. So please you look at this question, it's very important. Just look at June 2005 is asked, June 2006 again, now it is December 2006 again, same question. So it's very important questions. Already I have listed for this one in, I have explained in detail in June 2005 all the properties of logic gates. So just you go through it, all the properties. P means you should perfect these gates, you'll get one question definitely. So at least you should know which questions are very important, which questions are come frequently, they will ask on the which topic, which concept they will ask same question frequently. So you should thorough in that concepts. That's very important. So which of the following logic gate is fastest? It is characteristic, every time it will changes. It may be fastest, it may be maximum fan out, it may be power distribution. It may ask any type of characteristic based on the logic, but you should know the all the these list of logic gates, and just go you should know the what is the property of STL, what is the property of ECL, most important properties, and just remember these all points. I hope it's clear. You enjoyed this lecture series. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and share the channel. Please inform your friends. Thank you.